Everybody, GDC 2008, XNA Game Studio. Obviously, a huge present this year. A lot of big announcements even mentioned in the keynote. So we are here at the game lobby, and I'm with Michael. Michael, let's start off with what are some of the things you're showing off in this huge area all owned by XNA?
Yeah, we have the XNA lobby bar here this year, so we've got a lot of different things going on. We have community games that are currently available on Xbox Live Marketplace available for people to download.
Okay.
We have some games for Windows back behind us and just some regular Xbox games that have been published, like Call of Duty and that sort of thing,
right,
also available for people to play.
Fun, fun, fun. And now that's all running on XNA Game Studio 2.0, is that correct?
So the community games themselves are running on XNA Game Studio 2.0,
yes.
And the rest of the games are developed differently, but the community games are developed with that, and we made those available for people to download today.
Very awesome, very cool. Now, the big announcement this year is obviously XNA Game Studio 3.0, available to make games on your Zune, correct?
That's correct. So we announced just kind of the first announcement around XNA Game Studio 3.0. The big news is that you'll be able to develop games on your Zune for, and anybody can do it who downloads XNA Game Studio 3.0.
Very cool. And now, when will that be available? And it'll be free, I assume, correct?
Yes, it'll be free to download. We'll have a preview release coming out spring of this year.
Okay.
And then the final release will be out later around holiday of this year.
All right, so I know XNA Game Studio 3.0 isn't out just yet, but I did notice that you have a Zune in your hand with some games you mentioned, right?
Absolutely. We've been developing some games internally to try out the product for ourselves and have some information, you know, out there and some games
right.
People can try when they go to a session or something to learn more about Zune.
Awesome. So these are these are games made by the guys who made XNA. So these have got to be some pretty good games.
Yeah, we've tried to develop some good games. You know, we try to focus on developing the product as much as possible, but take a little bit of time and work on some games.
All right, well, let's take a look and see what the guys from XNA have created. Come here.
So this is a game called Zori, and this is what we showed in the keynote. It's just kind of a space shooter game where you fly around using the Zune pad. So you move your thumb around the Zune pad, and the ship moves with your thumb. And then you can shoot spaceships and fire bombs out and just basically work towards beating the boss.
Very fun. Do you have any more?
So another game that we have running is Hectic. So 2 years ago at GDC, when we first started talking about XNA, we had a version of Hexic running in managed code on the Xbox 360. So it made a lot of sense that we try to port that to the Zune and see how it behaves. So I can just basically start a new game, and this is familiar to anybody who has an Xbox 360 today, and they can essentially just play Hexic on the device. So it works very similar. You can select a group of things and rotate those around.
Nice work, Denise.
And you'll be able to clear out blocks and advance through the game.
All right, so you spoke about the community section going on over there, and it looks like there's a lot of hustle and bustle going on. What's the community aspect this year?
Absolutely. So also at GDC this year, we announced that anybody can take their XNA Game Studio 2.0 game on Xbox 360
right.
And basically make it available for other people to download, anybody who uses an Xbox 360
wow.
On Xbox Live Marketplace. So it's basically a distribution system for anybody who uses XNA Game Studio to make their games available
wow.
To the world.
And now, has that started already, or when will that start?
So it hasn't started yet. We haven't announced the time frame around that yet. What we have done today is made 7 of these community games available for a limited time that anybody on their Xbox 360 can go up to Xbox Live Marketplace and
wow.
Download those games.
That's awesome. That's quite an incentive. You guys better get out there and start making games. So I need something to play with. Now let's talk a little bit about the technical side of it. Suppose I develop a game with XNA Game Studio 3.0 for my Zune, and I want to share it with one of my friends. Is there sharing available, and will that happen wirelessly?
So the only sharing that you're going to have right now is to share your game out with other XNA Game Studio users, kind of like what people had before today on Xbox. So being able to just zip up your source code and send it to other people.
Right.
We're certainly interested in kind of how people respond to developing games on it and see where we take it from there. But right now we're pretty focused on just enabling people to develop games on the Zune.
Now this is pretty huge, and I know the people who out there who own a Zune are going to be really excited about this, about the new functionality of their, you know, previous media device. How long has this been in the works? Because, you know, no one told me.
Yeah, we've actually been working on this for about 6 to 8 months now. Wow. So we moved really quick with it. We kind of wanted to get it out there in front of people and start getting some reactions from the community and kind of really want to see what people try and develop on it.
Yeah, I'm sure. It's going to be awesome. I'm looking forward to it. What about things like copyrighted images and copyrighted music? Do you have any say? Obviously, once you put out the tools, there's nothing you can do with it. Nothing you can't rule over, right?
So, yeah, I mean, we certainly respect people's IP. We want our community to respect people's IP, you know, and play well. We have things in our framework to help make sure that, you know, you're following the guidelines set forth by copyrights and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So we definitely want to make sure that our partners and everything stay protected.
Obey the law, people. God, we're giving you free games. Obey the law. What has some of the audience response been? I know you just announced it a couple days ago. What are people saying? Is it just like, you know, a frenzy of excitement?
Yeah, it's been great. Like, people who have tried it have really been excited about it. They're really happy with what it looks like and the fact that you can write a game on Zune and then just take it to Xbox or Windows and have it run similarly on those platforms as well.
Awesome. And are there any other features for the 3.0 version that you want to sort of throw out right now, or is it sort of under lock and key at this point?
So we have a lot of it under lock and key. We will be supporting Visual Studio 2008, which was a big customer request that we had with our 2.0 release.
Great.
So that's a big thing. But beyond that, we don't have a lot right now that we're talking about on new features for Windows or Xbox.
Okay, but you will be releasing, and there will be more features announced. And where can people go to keep up to date on all the Game Studio 3.0 excitement?
Absolutely. They can go and get XNA Game Studio 2.0 now by heading to creators.xna.com.
Yes.
And they can also visit our forums and blog from there and find out what's going on with Zune and what are the current developments and news.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. I look forward to it. And thank you for giving me games on my Zune, hopefully, if you guys make them. Awesome.